former President Barack Obama's national security advisor, under fire for allegedly seeking to learn the names of Trump operatives communicating with foreign officials.
The allegation is that somehow Obama administration officials utilized intelligence for political purposes. That's absolutely false.
She insists that asking for the identities of Americans swept up in intelligence reports was part of her job as national security advisor.
There were occasions when I would receive a report in which a U.S. person was referred to, name not provided, just U.S. person. And sometimes in that context, in order to understand the importance of the report and assess its significance, it was necessary to find out or request the information as to who that U.S. official was.
Republicans are skeptical and say the matter warrants further investigation.
If it's the case, of course, it's just dereliction of duty. There's certain protocols that that person is very aware of, and if it's true, but first of all, we have to have factual evidence.
And the chairman of the Senate Intelligence Committee is not ruling out asking Rice to testify.
If there's intelligence that leads to her, she'll be part of the, our review.
Democrats say there's nothing unusual about the unmasking of individuals in intelligence reports and say the White House is seizing on Rice's alleged role to distract from the larger Russia investigation and to provide cover for the president's unsubstantiated tweets that Obama ordered wiretaps on Trump Tower.
I haven't seen anything that indicates that there was some effort to surveil or wiretap candidate Trump and his team. There's nothing to justify the tweets that he sent out. But we will be more than happy to review any concerns that are raised about incidental collection.
The Rice controversy, the latest in a saga that began when Republican Chairman Devin Nunes went to the White House last month to brief the president on intelligence he said showed some Trump transition officials' communications were incidentally picked up during legal surveillance operations. Nunes refusing to answer questions today.
Can you just stop for a second? Take one quick second.
No, I got to get into the...
Nunes told House Speaker Paul Ryan that the information came from a whistleblower, but it was later revealed at least two White House officials were reportedly involved in letting Nunes access the information.
What gives you confidence that it was a whistleblower and that Chairman Nunes was telling me truthful?
Yeah, I don't know who it was, but I'll just say this. Chairman Nunes has my confidence.